Today I'm here with Mark Longridge, who's our capital project manager. Remind us what this project is and why it's so important to the port.
Thanks, Mallory. So we're here having a look at the Pier 66 shore power project to bring crews shore power to Pier 66. We're just out in front of Terminal 46. Last time we were here, we had a look on the terminal where we've been doing a bunch of utility and duct bank work to bring power across the terminal. And today we're out on the water because we just completed our submarine cable installation in the middle of January. And we're excited to have that portion done as we get close to firing up our system and plugging in cruise ships.
Right. Yeah, last time we talked, we were in the process of building all the trenches. So we're connecting this from Terminal 46 to our Pier 66. Now we've laid the cable. How did that go? I heard you were fighting some winter weather.
We did this during the big Seattle freeze that we had in the middle of the month of January. Right around the holiday, the crew looked at the weather and we actually had ideal conditions for this cable lay. No wind, no waves, but very, very cold weather. So a little hard on the crews, but we were able to get it done and went off without a hitch, went really well.
How much of the cable is underwater?
Yeah, so the cable is just over a mile long. It's about 6,100 feet. It's a pretty healthy size. It weighs about 22 pounds a foot and is about 6 inches in diameter. So the cable is pretty substantial. It weighs about 68 tons total weight. They place it within about 3 feet of the design area at all locations, but it's laid across, and like I said, we did it in one day. The crews were remarkable, like I said, dealing with quite a bit of cold weather. They really stepped up, and we had cable laying experts there, our partners, Orion, also the port crews in support, and some designer support as well. Really a team effort to get that in. We laid right across Elliott Bay through the active ferry lanes, working with vessel traffic, the Coast Guard, the Washington State Ferries. So it really was a team effort to get it put in, and I really appreciate the help of everyone to get it done.
Amazing, and that is good news for a lot of reasons, one of which is its environmental impact. So connecting cruise ships connecting to shore power helps to reduce emissions. We're using clean energy that brings Seattle City Light. And with this, all of our cruise terminals will be shore power capable.
That's correct, yeah. The Port of Seattle has been shore power capable at the 291 berths, one of the first areas that was available, and we're really excited to bring this on board. We've been working hard, like I said, with our designers, permitting agencies, the Seattle City Light partners that we have, our industry partners, and it's really been a team effort. Everyone's very excited to get this completed.
So we're here at Terminal 46. Where is Pier 66?
So Pier 66, just underneath the Space Needle there, you can see behind the ferry, that's where our cable ends up and comes up through the pier.
Great, let's go check it out.
All right.
All right, so we've traveled the mile above the cable, and now we're here at Pier 66. What's gonna happen next here? We're doing some construction?
That's correct. So, like I said, we pulled up the cable here. The cable has now up on top of the deck. We have some electrical equipment that the port has bought that's gonna be arriving in the spring. And we need to get prepared to install that. We have a bunch of underdock conduit work that's going on right now to bring the power over to where the cruise ships will plug in. We're hoping by about midsummer that we should be able to ready to fire the system up and use it.
Well, thank you, Mark, for joining us. We'll check back in the summer when it's a little bit warmer and the project is almost complete. For the Port of Seattle, I'm Mallory Hauser. Thanks for diving in.